Do your clients want more detail on the invoices that you send them for reimbursable job expenses? Well, then you need to know how to record billing for expense items. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Expense items are items that vendors provide for us, and when we purchase them, they get placed on a check or a bill from a vendor. The item is attached to an expense type of account the same way that the income items are attached to an income type of account and placed on an invoice for service that we give to the clients. You see, here's our items list, and it's very extensive at this point in the course. But we remember when we set up the items list, the items were connected to an income type of account in the chart of accounts, so that when we placed it on an invoice, the income account that was connected to the item goes up. Now we have expense items on the items list, and we will connect the expense items to an expense type of account the same way that we connected the income item to the income type of account, so that this way when we place it on a transaction, the account automatically increases. So, expense items are the same idea as the income items, except they're attached to expense items and placed on vendor-related transactions. But the big question is, why do we need them? Well, up until now, billable expenses only had the expense account listed in the transaction. There was no detail about the items purchased or what you're actually billing the client at the moment you put it on an invoice. There is no detail that shows on the invoice, like what item it was and what quantity and so on. So you see, if we use an item instead of just using the expense account that we're billing for, then we'll have more detail, and the detail shows on the invoice so the client can see what expense they are being billed for, and more specifically, what item of that expense. For example, supplies expense. If you just bill the client for supplies, they don't know what's going on. But supplies expense could mean envelopes, stamps, paper, the specific thing that you used in the quantity that you used them. The supplies expense is the account in the chart of accounts, but these three things on the right would be items that would go on the items list that would be connected to the supplies expense account so that you could bill for that level of detail and have the same numbers affect your chart of accounts while giving the clients the details that they need. Let's add two items to the items list just to see how this works. Let's add envelopes and stamps, and we'll connect them to the supplies expense account. So from the main menu, we click List, Items List, and in the bottom left, we click Item, New. Now, this will be a service, and the name of the service will be envelopes. And you can pause the video to type it in, but it's connected to the supplies expense account. Now, let's click Next, and notice it leaves the supplies expense account here, and let's put stamps. And click OK. Now we have the two items on the list that are connected to the expense account. Now let's imagine on January 25th, we purchased 7 envelope boxes for $3 each and 5 stamp packages at $4 each from Staples. And let's imagine they're both billable to the Lillian Court job under Brown Company. Well, what would happen in the trial balance if we purchase these items by using the items on the items list? Well, the total is $41. So supplies expense would increase by the $41 and become $291. And the cash in bank that we're paying the money for would decrease by the $41 and become $8,059 from this transaction, 7 at 3 and 5 at 4. So let's go ahead and record the transaction. We click banking, write a check, and the date would be January 25th of 2018. In our little story. Now, we purchased the supplies from Staples, and we're going to write a check even though we have unpaid bills, but you must be careful down here. You must remove any expense account that shows down here, because now we're not using expense accounts, we are instead using items. And notice, the items are on the items list, so it's envelopes. And what's the quantity and purchase cost? 7 envelopes at $3 each, billable to Lillian Court. 7 envelopes, $3 each, and click no, because we reserve the right to change the cost and the price at each transaction. And it's Lillian Court and it's billable, but we're not done. We also have to put on stamps. And stamps, the quantity in this transaction is 5 at $4 each. 5 stamps, 5 units of stamps or books of stamps at $4 each. Let's not memorize the cost and the price, but let's make it billable to the Lillian Court job. And this is what your check should look like if you're using items. Remember, the expense tab should be clear and it should only be in items. Do not type in a money amount up top. The items will calculate the money amount total and put it up top. Now we hit enter to save it, and when we open the trial balance, the results are exactly as what we expected. Supplies expense is $291, just like we predicted. And cash in Chase Bank is $8,059, just like we expected. Are we finished checking results? Well, the numbers look good in the trial balance, but you must always check the profit and loss by client to see that the expense items were tracked to the right place. So if we click profit and loss by job, which is profit and loss by client, look under Lillian Court, the column of Lillian Court under Brown Company, and you can see supplies expense increased by $41. $250 was for Mockingbird Lane, but this $41 was specifically for Lillian Court, and they add up to the total supplies expense that was in the trial balance. Now, the interesting part. Now we'll actually bill Betty for the supplies. So let's imagine on January 29th, we billed Betty for the January 25th supply purchase. So what happens when we use expense items and then we bill for them? Well, these are what we call one-sided items, which means they're only connected to one account. Which means when you bill for them, you have no choice. Supplies expense that originally went up when you purchased now goes back down when you bill. Because when you bill the client is now responsible for paying that $41. So your company no longer has $41 in supplies expense. That's why it went back down. And if the client is responsible for it, it means they owe more. It means accounts receivable increases by the $41 that you bill to the client for these reimbursable job expenses. Very, very simple. Invoice and make sure the date is proper at January 29th. And then we'll choose Lillian Court. And you can see we will not. We will not match this invoice against the estimate because it's for reimbursable expenses. Just click cancel. But we will, watch carefully, add billable time and cost to the invoice. Now, when you click OK, notice before we click the expense tab when we were doing billable expenses, but now all the only things available are the billable items. Because we put them in as items, they would be in this tab. We choose both of them. Now we will agree with the price each because we will not mark them up. You're not able to properly mark them up without a problem by using this type of item. If you need to bill them for more than what you paid for, you have to watch the video that follows this one for two-sided items so that you can mark them up without causing a problem. But we'll get to that in a moment. Right now, you're billing the client for $41. So we hit enter, and at the moment we open the trial balance, you can see that the results are exactly as what we expected. Supplies expense went back down. Look, I'm going to double click. It went up by $41 when we paid for it. It went down by $41 when we billed the client. And the client is now responsible for that $41 added to account receivable. Lastly, let's check the profit and loss by client. If we open the report, profit and loss by job, and we look in the Lillian Court column, we see that supplies expense specifically for Lillian Court has disappeared. We no longer have that supplies expense because the client now owes us for that expense. You can learn everything you need in QuickBooks regarding contractor features by watching the full playlist that this video is a part of. You can just click the link in the comment field or under the first paragraph in the description field, and there's also links in the top right of the video as it plays.